In this Q&A video, we'll be answering the question, when calculating grouping for a cable tray, do I need to count every cable on there? Now, this question relates to numerous videos that Gordon and Gary have made on cable tray and basket from Atkore, so check those videos out to see more details of those items. But in this video, we're going to look at a technical question relating to grouping factor on cable tray and basket. Now, we all know why grouping factors are important. Ultimately, when current passes through a conductor, it generates heat. If excessive, this heat can cause the insulation on the conductor to break down, and in some cases, cause damage to the fabric of the building and may even start a fire. So, if a cable needs to carry more current, we install a larger cable. It's not just that the copper is physically capable of carrying more current. A cable with a larger cross-sectional area can dissipate its heat more effectively. So, managing the safe dissipation of this heat is absolutely critical to making sure that our installations are safe. Now, when we install cables together onto a tray, the fact that the cables are touching or even just in close proximity means that they can't dissipate their heat as effectively because the heat from each cable will affect its neighbours. This means that the cable cannot be allowed to get as hot as it could do if it was by itself. Table 4C1 in BS 7671 gives a factor that gets used to effectively increase the maximum current a cable must be able to carry, and in reality, this results in needing a cable with a larger cross-sectional area. So let's look at an example. If we've got 8 cables fixed to a tray feeding 8 lighting circuits, we look at item 3 of table 4C1 in the wiring regs and track across to find the column marked 8. Looking at where they intersect, we've got a value of 0.72. Now, this factor goes into a calculation that helps us to determine conductor size, and it looks like this. IT must be greater than or equal to IN divided by CG. In this formula, IT is the tabulated value of current that the cable can carry. Tabulated just means in a table, by the way. IN is the nominal rating of the circuit protective device, and CG is the grouping factor that we just found. Now, there's a whole load of other rating factors that we can put under here to keep the grouping factor company, but we'll cover those in other videos. So if we're considering this lighting circuit protected by a 10 amp MCB, then the cable we install must be able to carry more than 10 divided by 0.72, so 13.9 amps, and then we'd select the correct cable accordingly. But is that the end of the story? In this case, do we really need to use all 8 cables to figure out our grouping factor? Well, there is a way that may allow us to discount some of those conductors. Note 9 to the table sheds a little bit of light on this. It reads, if, due to known operating conditions, a cable is expected to carry not more than 30% of its grouped rating, it may be ignored for the purpose of obtaining the rating factor for the rest of the group. So in other words, if the cross-sectional area of the cable is bigger than it needs to be, which sometimes happens to make the circuit have a compliant volt drop or earth fault loop impedance value, then we may not need to include it in our calculation for grouping. This is because the circuit is not drawing enough to make the cable hot enough to cause a problem. But there's 2 points just to be careful about. First of all, this is only applicable if there are known operating conditions. In other words, you know what the circuit is feeding and that it is not likely to change. So a socket circuit would not be a suitable candidate for this allowance. But a lighting circuit with a fixed and known number of lights on might. Also notice it read not more than 30% of its grouped rating. What does this mean? Well, the note continues. For example, a group of N loaded cables would normally require a group rating factor of CG applied to the tabulated IT. However, if M cables in the group carry loads which are not greater than 0.3 CG IT amperes, the other cables can be sized by using the group rating factor corresponding to N minus M cables. So let's try and unravel that one. Suddenly, this note is telling us that the grouping factor needs to be applied to the tabulated current carrying capacity of the cable. But earlier, we applied the grouping factor to the nominal rating of the protective device. So what's going on there? Well, looking back to our formula from earlier, if we transpose it, we'll find that the current carrying capacity multiplied by our grouping factor must be greater than the nominal rating of the protective device. Which kind of makes sense, as we want the cable to be able to carry more current in the conditions it's installed in than the protective device will allow to flow. So if, as it says in the final sentence of the note, the grouping factor times the tabulated current carrying capacity times 0.3 for the 30% is higher than the current expected to flow, then you don't need to count that cable in your grouping calculation. So if your tabulated current carrying capacity was 17 amps, multiply it by the grouping factor of 0.72 and by 0.3, and you get 3.672. If the circuit should never draw more than that value of current, for instance, if it's feeding a fixed amount of light fittings, then you don't need to include it in your grouping factor value. Now that's all well and good, however, amazingly, it's only scraping the surface of grouping, and there's lots of other things to bear in mind also, such as the fact that note 1 states that the values in table 4C1 are only applicable to uniform groups of cables equally loaded. So the question arises, what about when you have groups of cables that are non-uniform and unequally loaded? Well, that's the subject of a future video, but we've made a good start here. As always, we want to hear from you. Do you use grouping factors in your electrical work, or has note 9 to table 4C1 ever made a difference to an installation that you've been designing or installing? Whatever your thoughts or questions on this subject, please leave them in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.